and we'll continue to bring you more updates on severe thunderstorms developing across the plains. Wait a minute, is that a giant cat behind me? I've had it.
Welcome to another episode of Fast Forward. Today, we're just outside of Atlanta visiting one of my favorite places, the Weather Channel. You see, I'm kind of a knucklehead when it comes to weather. At least I thought I was until I met some of the people who work here.
I love clouds.
I love seeing thunderstorms bubble on the horizon.
My name's Danielle, and I'm a cloudaholic.
Yep, these folks are really into weather. So let's start with the tough questions. We've all seen movies with tornadoes. Can a tornado really make a cow fly?
Yes, a tornado can make a cow fly, and unfortunately, it's happened.
Cool. Kind of like cow tipping, taken to the extreme? All right, enough fooling around. Let's learn a little more about this place.
So I am one of about 200 meteorologists here at the Weather Channel, but I'm really only about one of a couple dozen meteorologists that go on camera. The other 100 and some change meteorologists are working behind the scenes. They're creating our weather forecasts. They are working on developing our weather forecasts, making them better. Graphics that go on air at the Weather Channel, some are created by meteorologists. And then we have about 1,000 people total that work at the Weather Channel. People who work in advertising, in marketing, in graphic design, in technology development, in finance. So you need people of all different expertise to pull together a company like this.
But there's something I forgot to ask. Technically speaking, what is weather?
Weather, to me, is everything.
Well, what creates weather is essentially the difference in the way that the sun heats different regions of the Earth. That, in turn, drives wind patterns, pressure patterns.
Okay, these folks really know their stuff, and they obviously take weather very seriously.
People around here call me the dew point diva.
Maybe I spoke too soon, but let's see where this goes.
A lot of meteorologists find it very useful to look at the dew points every day as a forecasting tool. But plus, dew points tell you if it's going to be a good hair day or not. Believe it or not, you can use human hair to figure out how humid it is outside, because when it's really humid, the hair is going to shrink up. And on days when it's not quite as humid out, when the dew point is lower, the hair lengthens.
Okay, good to know that there's actually science behind bad hair days. I just wish there was an excuse for bedhead. Incidentally, the dew point Jennifer mentioned also affects how we feel in moist heat versus dry heat.
If you put a thermometer out in the air, it'll measure a certain temperature.
However, in the summer and the winter, people are more interested in the feels-like temperature.
In the summertime, your body tries to cool itself by evaporating moisture off. That's why you sweat. Sweat is a cooling process. When it's real humid outside, you can't evaporate sweat as effectively, so you feel hotter. The body isn't cooling itself. So when it's a real humid day, what's called the heat index, or the real field temperature, will be higher.
Conversely, in the winter, you take into account the wind.
When we have strong winds and cold air, the strong winds strip a layer of warm molecules right above the skin away.
And that wind's blowing, and it makes the air feel even colder on your skin.
And sometimes you'll hear about that as the wind chill temperature.
Okay, while we've got access to the experts, let's see what else we can learn about weather. Tell us more about those clouds.
I love to talk about clouds.
So what clouds are a visible image of liquid droplets or water suspended within the atmosphere.
When you see the puffy clouds, the cotton ball-like clouds, those are cumulus clouds. If the cumulus clouds build really high in the sky, those are the thunderstorm clouds. And then when you have the clouds that are sort of like a cotton ball that just gets stretched out really thin, kind of like gauze, well, those are stratus clouds. And when they're really dark, they're nimbostratus clouds, and those are the ones that bring rain.
Good stuff.
Now let's go to the lightning round.
No, seriously, this is where we talk about lightning. What is it?
What is lightning?
Lightning, it's a discharge of electricity between cloud and ground, or from cloud to cloud. It occurs when ice crystals collide inside of clouds.
And you get a separation of charges that happens because these particles are rubbing together.
Eventually, that difference has to be released in a very huge electrical spark that we see as a lightning bolt.
I've always heard heat lightning isn't dangerous.
Your mom says, it's just heat lightning. That's an old wives' tale.
Did she just call my mom an old wife? Then what is it?
Heat lightning is basically lightning that's far away.
Heat lightning is the real deal. Any lightning is the real deal. And if you can see lightning or if you can hear thunder, go inside. When thunder roars, go indoors.
I think I've got it. Weather is the result of the sun's radiation on different parts of the Earth. Lightning is the release of energy caused by colliding ice particles high above us. And in a tornado, always keep an eye out for flying cows. Oh, and if you want a shot at working at a place like the Weather Channel, check out weather.com and have a conversation with your science teacher. They can help you get information about internships and maybe give you a little extra help in the classes that'll impress the folks at the Weather Channel the most. And if you have any luck, we might just see you on a future episode of Fast Forward.